Hello, my name is Doug Hubble, and welcome to Planetary Imaging and Processing Part 6. Today we will go through the steps for processing the moon. You can download this data in the comments section below. Let's get started. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is open up Registax. Registax is a free program you can download. What you do next is you go ahead and you select the image that you're going to use. This one has the moon, so I'm going to open that up. And if you follow Registax keys on here, it usually highlights and points out the areas with green highlights, arrows, so it's kind of intuitive to get you started on your processing steps. The one thing that we want to do is first is set the align points, and if you use this scroll bar to kind of go through the images, you can see how it moves across the image here. And what we want to try to do is try to find a frame that's pretty good to set the align points on. So just kind of scrub back and forth, and when you find one that looks pretty good or getting down to it, you can use the arrow keys to go left or right on it and then kind of like find one that looks pretty good. This one looks pretty nice there, so I'm just gonna go ahead and hit set points. And as you can see, it set all these align points on the image. So the next step is we're going to do is hit align. And what it's going to do now is it's going to run through all the frames and align them up so we can begin to stack it. You can see right down here it has 896 frames in this video. So it's going to go through all of them. You can see down here it's 75-80% done now. And as soon as it gets done, we'll do a limit. Now, right here where it says best frames, you don't want to take 100% of your frames. If you do that, you're just going to get some of the noisy, out of focus, be about 50%. You only want the best quality frames to go through here. You can see right now at 50%, it's doing 449 frames out of 896. So what we'll do now is we'll hit limit, and the next thing we'll do is we'll hit the stack button. Of course, it just goes ahead and highlights the areas which you need to do, so I'll go ahead and hit stack. Okay, so now it's stacked the image. Now the last step you can do is you can do a little bit of wavelet processing of the image. The wavelet is kind of like a sharpening tool to bring out some more detail. The one thing you'll notice is that it has these different layers, 1 through 6. The sixth layer is kind of like for larger structures. It's not the fine detail sharpening, whereas something as like number 1, it's very fine detail sharpening that's in there. And if you noticed, if I drag this over pretty far, you can see that how it's changed in appearance. I wouldn't go too far on these. I like to kind of like let me see here. I like to also use the linked wavelets as well. And I would say just something very mild, a mild sharpening on it. I don't want to get too crazy on it here. Again, you're going to have to play around with this, kind of like see what works best for your image. That looks pretty good to me. I'm going to go ahead and say do all, and then save the image. Okay, and now the next step is we're going to go into Photoshop and do a little bit of post-processing. I have this image opened up in Photoshop, and one of the things I like to do in Photoshop is using the high-pass filter for sharpening. And the combination of using a high-pass filter and layer masks will give you the precise details that you want to put on your image. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to make a copy of the image. And what I'll do is I'll go to filter, other, high pass. And for this first sharpening that I'm going to do, I'm going to do just the fine detail. So I don't want a very large radius. I'm going to pick something that looks, I don't know, about 7 looks pretty good there. And what I'll do is I'll say okay. Now I'm going to take the mode on this layer, and I'm going to change that to overlay. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to apply a layer mask. Now, layer mask is an astrophotographer's best friend in Photoshop. You can take a layer mask and say hide all. So what it's done now is it's put this black cover over it, and what it will allow us to do is take like a white paintbrush and poke holes in it where we want to bring out the detail and not sharpen up the entire image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the brush tool. I'm using the open and close square brackets to make it larger or smaller, or you could just hit up here under the brush tool and just, you know, slide it there to get you the diameter you want. But I'm going to start painting some details on here. I'm going to start, you know, going to the tops of the craters. And you know what I like is I like this nice detail from the impact, where I guess the impact zone created these nice little fanning gullies and ravines off of it. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight that. And I also see some other little tiny highlights I'd like to bring out over here. So the layer mask allows you to bring out the details that you want without, you know, changing it on the entire image, which is a very powerful tool. So right now we're just doing some sharpening, but there's other tools inside of Photoshop with a layer mask that you can bring out these details that you might need on a particular spot on your image. Okay, so that does a good job there. Next step is to go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And what I want to do on this is the blur will give it a nice blending effect. And now you can see right here with no blur on it, that's what I painted out, and those are the details I wanted on the image. Now I don't want to get too much of a blur on it. About 10 looks pretty good there. You can see it's getting a little bit of a blending to the image there. So I'm gonna say okay. Now this right here, this is going to be the fine detail. So I'm gonna call fine details. And I'm going to turn that off now. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make another copy of this background. And this time what I'm going to do is I'm going to do another filter other high pass. And this time, instead of sharpening the fine details, I'm going to go for the larger structures. And I'm going to say about, I don't know, 45, 48, something in that area. That looks pretty good right there. So I'm going to say okay. And this time I'm going to change the blending mode from normal to soft light. And again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a layer mask and go to layer mask, hide all. And remember, we got this little black mask. Now we can poke holes in it with our white brush. So I'm going to, by the way, I'm double clicking on that so I can get control of my my brush tool with the open and square bracket. So now I'm going to take a larger brush size. You know, it's like now it's up to 100, and I'm just going to paint in some of these, you know, larger structures here to give it the sharpening effect that I like. There we go. That looks pretty good. Now, as you can see, I poked a really gigantic hole inside there with that that brush. But now I'm going to go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And this time, instead of a small radius, I want to make a nice gentle blend with it. So I'm going to crank this up until it looks like it's got a good blend to it. You can see how that transition is like a nice smooth transition. You really can't see that sharpening effect because it blends in nicely. Okay, so now what we have is we've got the coarse sharpening, and then we're going to turn on this other layer for the fine sharpening, for the fine details, and you get the best of both there. Now, these steps that we've done with Registax and now post-processing with Photoshop, we've come a long way. Like, here's what the image looked like on a single frame from the video compared to after we've post-processed it. And you can see there's a pretty dramatic difference. So using the Registax and maybe a little bit of post-processing, you can really have some dramatic results on your shots there. The last thing you can do if you want to save it for people on the web or sharing it is I like to hit File, Save for Web Devices, and you can use this tool right here to change however high you want it to be as far as quality. You can see down here it tells you the size of the image. Some places when you share them, your images, there's file size limits and stuff like that. So you can kind of look around in there. If you're going to go to a print quality or you wanted to use something to print on a photo, I would definitely use maximum on there, and then you hit save. If this is your first time watching, I'd like you to subscribe to my channel. I publish 2 astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th of every month. Coming up next, I'll show you how to take t-shirt flats. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.